Welcome back to Pitch 1 at George Square for Austria against Slovenia in Group H. So again, we're in the bottom half of the draw, and Group H involves Cambodia, Finland, Norway, these two, Austria, Slovenia and Greece. And it's all change in the commentary box as well. Celebrity change in the commentary box, and a hero in one half of Glasgow, I must say. Bobby Petta, former Celtic player, is here with me. Bobby, thank you so much for coming up.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Welcome along. How much of the Homeless World Cup have you seen so far?
I've seen the Dutch squad playing there, the guys' team, and it was interesting. It goes very quick. I mean, you're one up, and it can be two and down in the space of a minute. So it's good. It's good to see everybody here for one thing, you know. And it's a good atmosphere.
And what do you make of the tournament as a whole? Not necessarily just from a footballing point of view, but what it does for all the people that are playing in it.
I mean, it's just great to be part of, you know, an event like this, where people from different backgrounds, but then again, similar backgrounds, come together for one purpose and have a good time, and hopefully be a winner here. Regardless of who's going to win the tournament, everybody's going to be a winner, you know. And it's just football again brings people together from all you know, ages and backgrounds, and I think it's just great to see that, especially for Glasgow. It's great because, you know, Glasgow is what people make Glasgow, and I think there's a great atmosphere, very hospitable, and to have an event like this, it just it suits Glasgow, I think, in my opinion.
And Glasgow is very much your adopted home these days. You've been here for quite a long time now.
I've been here long enough. I've been here for a while, yeah.
So since stopping playing with Celtic, how long have you been here? You brought your business here?
What I've done is I've stopped playing when I was in Australia. And then I came back here in 2010 and started to do the personal training business. And it's tough. It's not that easy. But I try to again give something back to the society, to football, which has given me a lot. So we'll keep plodding away.
I'll be down for a session soon enough. So you've seen the Dutch side,
yes,
of course, a team that you had involvement with as a player, as Austria go 1-0 up.
Yes.
You have a close relationship with one of the Dutch coaches, I believe.
Yeah, he's my former teammate when we were played for RKC. René van Rijswijk. He used to have a very long hair. If you see him now, he's kind of bald, and it suits him better, actually, to be honest. But we go way back 22 years. So I haven't seen him for each other for maybe 21 years. So it's good to see him. See each other again, of course, and bring back memories and support, obviously, the Dutch teams. So it's been good to see him.
Now, what about in terms of football, mm-hmm, and the style of football that gets played here? Because having grown up watching yourself, mm-hmm, I can imagine that this is the type of game that you would quite enjoy. Quick turn of pace, the quick twinkle toes to get past a man.
Yeah, it is, because obviously you gotta get one up, so there's an overload, 3 versus 2, and if you're clever, you should score every single time, you know what I mean? It's fast, as I said, you can be one up and could be a couple goals behind straight away. It's just there's a bit of tactics involved, a bit of strategy. We need a bit of communication as well, because otherwise, you know, there's gonna be people really being free and be able to score with no pressure on them.
Yeah, as you say, there's certainly no respite. It's a small pitch, but yeah, only 4 people having to cover it. Mm-hmm. And as you say, if you get caught out, maybe somebody a bit too relaxed loses their man, then mm-hmm, suddenly, you know, the goalkeeper's faced with a 2-on-1.
Yeah, no, exactly. I mean, you got to use the goalkeeper. You can only use it once, I think. And it's always going to be an overload. And obviously, you can't go into the D, but it's interesting to see everybody. If you keep your shape, you're always going to have a shot. That's unlucky.
Did you have the ball stuck between his feet? Did you have managers during your time as a professional footballer who would like to practice with this style of game?
When we were younger, you play 3-3-3, and there's always somebody, even though you weren't told to stay up, you would stay up, and kind of cheat out of it. So there was always kind of been an overflow. So you get taught how to play it out. And that's it starts when we were younger, to be honest. 8, 9 years old, start playing this kind of way.
Well, and certainly we can all learn from the Netherlands and how to produce the best young players as well.
Well, at the moment they're producing a lot of good players, but you know, in a tournament they don't really necessarily get the results that they want. A lot of good individuals, but as a team it doesn't really always click, you know. But
it's actually refreshing to have somebody up here that isn't talking about the European Championships, because the Netherlands,
talk about.
The Netherlands and Scotland didn't make it, so I've been trying to be as quiet as possible.
Oh, what a miss.
Great chance there for Austria.
It's unbelievable, right? The goals are very low and everybody's aiming high for whatever reason.
It might work as good rugby players.
Oh, well, 6 points all the time, eh?
Quick passing from Austria, but unable to release number five.
Yeah, you see they have a structure in place there, nice combination play, etc.
Shall we avoid talk of Celtic's result last night as well, Bobby?
No, it's interesting actually, because I do remember that when, for example, Dick Advocaat was his first year at Rangers, they went to Ireland and they lost that leg by a few goals. And then at home they won it, so they won the tie. So okay, 1-0 is not great anyways, but it's obviously they're gonna win the second leg and they're gonna go through. But everybody's looking obviously at the new manager, and we then look at the players. You can't blame the manager because he's trying to figure out what's the best team and where it needs to improve. Celtic needs quite a few players to improve on, to be honest with you. I mean. Everybody's saying if Ambrose made another mistake, and I watched it and I was like, yeah, another individual error that's costing a goal, you know, especially against these players. No disrespect, but they're part-timers, so you should beat them. Whether it's one goal difference or a few, it doesn't matter. You need to beat them. It'll not be easy, but you should be able to, you know, do that. But football for you.
For those around the world, we do have viewers from over 120 different countries. Bobby used to play for Celtic here in Glasgow. They were playing last night and lost out to a side from Gibraltar called the Lincoln Red Imps. So well done to the Lincoln Red Imps, and they'll be back in Glasgow next week for the return leg. But it's incredible when you think of the numbers that either are coming through here at George Square, where there's been well over 20,000 people have come through the gates and continuing to flood in, and online as well, over 1 million people have been watching us.
Oh, that's great. It's great viewing, and it's a good, people watching it, and especially with the weather. It's Scottish weather, so everybody's still here. It's busy, a good vibe in George Square, and hopefully tomorrow is going to be like it is right now. Blue skies and good weather. And the last, it's still Sunday, isn't it?
The finals are all on Saturday, so we've got to an interesting stage of the tournament whereby the first 3 days separated out the top teams and those at a lower level. And now we've got four groups of six competing in the top section.
Right.
Four groups of six in the men's competition in the bottom half. So they all play each other again. And then on Saturday, we get to the knockout phases.
Right.
And they all compete for six different cup competitions.
Right, that's good.
So it's quite complicated.
It's complicated, but everybody's a winner. Sort of thing. Everybody can go away with something.
Oh, you can see more and more people getting involved using the hashtag on Twitter, HWC2016. And we have our first headed goal of the tournament. We saw that in the last game from Switzerland. And it was their number 9, Raphael Garrott, who got it. And Austria back underway quickly. They are 2-0 to the good here against Slovenia. So Bobby, you obviously keep fit. Work keeps you fit from now on. Are you still playing football? Any of your old teammates still?
Yeah, I do a lot of things. Every month there's like an old firm game, where it's 5-a-side games or it's just one full game. So you got a few former Celtic players and a few Rangers players, and the rest is all people that want to play with us. And every month, sort of thing, we have got a game. And how to keep myself fit, that's how I still keep kicking a ball. And obviously, then I do my personal training, and I did it with some decent youth players. Apart from that, do a lot of boxing, so keeps me fit.
And I'm sure those old firm games are as quiet and friendly as ever.
Oh, they're always very quiet.
Celtic and Rangers, the two big teams here in Glasgow, a famous rivalry. Austria giving up the opportunity from the penalty. Of course, you'll be used to the 11-a-side penalty where you get to shoot from 12 yards. The striker's expected to score. Here, it's quite difficult. The small goals, and as the goalkeeper rushes out, there's not a lot of space.
Exactly, closes the angle. So it's good. It's like they took it over from the ice hockey, isn't it? So I think it's... And you have to move forward, haven't you? You can't stop and go backwards, can you? So it's good. I prefer that towards a penalty, to be honest with you.
I remember them also using it in the MLS. I think they run it in from halfway. If it goes to a penalty shootout,
yes,
run in one-on-one with the goalkeeper.
I think it makes it more interesting because, you know, penalties are penalties. Like, it's a big gamble, but I think they change that because, okay, it's just shooting a ball on goal, but this, you really have to think, are you going to shoot or are you going to pass the goalkeeper? There's a lot more things you have to think about.
So football can learn a lot from this tournament.
All right, I tell you. It is not... Oh, it's like an old goal.
Mistake by the Slovenian goalkeeper there. I tell you what, the other thing. You don't see any diving here. Not that I would accuse you of such a thing.
You can't dive here. No, these guys are just going for it, don't they? I mean, especially when you go towards the boarding, you just... it can be quite sore if you...
Took it well. Fine finish by the Austrian number 6, Mohamed Reza Mejidi. So what's your plan for the rest of the day? Are you going to take in a few more games, Bobby?
Yeah, I'm going to see a few more of these games and have a few look around and look at some of the stuff here, you know, to go on. The merchandise tents, I quite like those wee jumpers. So a bit of advertising too.
Well, and if you're interested, the Dutch women's team are playing at 4:10, and you should watch out for their number 4. Mm-hmm. You might be able to actually help with the pronunciation if I can find the sheet, but I think it's something like Vercruce. Fantastic player, number 4, and she's been one to watch out in the whole tournament.
I see, that's what I like about this tournament as well, this men and male and female here. And
well, and also, quite interestingly...
Mixed, some are mixed, some teams.
Some of the male teams are mixed, in particular Australia, Brazil.
Yeah.
Brazil have two girls who come on, and they certainly don't weaken the side. They're very strong players.
Sometimes may strengthen, okay.
South Africa as well. There's a player for them that came on in their last game, and it was tied at 5-5. Mm-hmm. She came on, struck a wonderful goal to win the game. On the back of her shirt, Messi. So they got her nickname right, that's for sure.
Okay. Here you go, finish it off.
Oh, good save by the goalkeeper. Number 12 for Slovenia is Drago Savic. At Austria.
Oh, score. Oh!
Trying to get another goal to just take them further clear. Slovenia yet to find the back of the net.
A sniper. There's a sniper somewhere.
They don't hold back with the tackles either.
No, they don't.
You'll notice that particularly in the top half of the men's section. Now they've got through the first half of the draw.
Right.
It's now getting quite competitive. Okay. There's a few tackles flying in that competition. Nobody wants to lose.
No, surely not.
But it's one of those tournaments that everyone's a winner anyway.
Yeah. Oh, there's another one falling. Another sniper. See, this is the thing with these games. Once the goalkeeper's got a ball, you got to go and look forward, look long straight away to your striker. This is a small pitch.
Well, and also,
too congested.
As you were talking about the ruling that keeps one defensive player in the opposition half at all times,
yeah.
he can therefore be, you know, he can goal poach.
Yeah, he could goal poach, and you don't stay in the middle, you stay on the side. So if I was a lefty, I would stay on the right side all the time. Get the ball, and then it's easy to control it.
So with just a minute left to play, Austria looking good to register a victory in this group match. Oh. From the tight angle, unable to find the empty net.
Oh, he missed a couple. He missed two. That's two in a row he missed. Here we go. What's he going to do here?
Go number four. He doesn't miss this time. The Austrian number four, Markus Kumurka. So if you're looking for a tip of who to go and watch, other than the Netherlands women, because I know you'll watch Holland, whoever they're playing.
I will watch them, exactly.
Mexico,
yeah.
Mexico, men and women.
Didn't that be one of the last year?
Yes, both of them. Both men of them, and women, yeah. Double winners. And in particular, the women this year, very, very strong. The men, that competition's going to be very exciting. Brazil,
yeah, look out for that.
Bulgaria, South Africa, lots of very, very good teams. And this game comes to an end, a 6-0 victory for Austria against Slovenia. What did you make of the game? What was the difference? What did Austria have that Slovenia maybe didn't, Bobby?
A lot more positivity, and they finished the chances. So they got some, I think, a better quality overall, and deserve to go through. You know, I mean, get the win there. So it's good football, good football.
Well, you can see some of the best of the action of the Austrians here as well. There's your man, the number four, tucking away the final goal.
He had to score that one. He missed two already from like a yard, 2 yards out. So. Now you can see that the quality is just a bit better from Austria. So obviously deserve to win that game. So
and Markus Kumurka answered his critics in the end.
I like seeing this, you know what I mean? I like seeing this.
Well, this is fantastic. Yeah. Every game, all the players arm in arm and thanking the crowd for their involvement. Great to see you joining the conversation on Twitter as well with the hashtag HWC2016. And remember, of course, you can donate to the Homeless World Cup. Text GOAL to 70660 for a £5 donation. And there are also so many ways, as the tweets keep coming through. MG Green, thanks to Megan and the GCU physio students helping out at the Homeless World Cup in Glasgow. Great experience. And you can get involved on Twitter by tweeting at Homeless World Cup, no O in world, and using the hashtag HWC2016. Facebook.com/Homeless World Cup, where they're streaming all the games live. Also, YouTube.com/Homeless World Cup. Where you can watch highlights of every game around about 15 or 20 minutes after the action. Bobby Petter, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
You've brought the sunshine back to Glasgow. Get out and enjoy it. Enjoy the games.
I will.
And let's cheer the Dutch players on to some victories.
Oh, you're telling you to need it.
Well, thank you, Bobby. Well
thanks
done.
Again. Thank you.